Hello everyone, I'm Luca Vedovelli. I'm presenting you Simulomics R, a package for generating reliable omics data using generative in artificial intelligence model. Simulating biological data has become an important aspect of many research studies in the field of system biology. The ability to generate reliable simulated data can facilitate the development and testing of new methods for analyzing omics data, such as feature selection or statistical analysis techniques. However, creating reliable simulated data that accurately reflects the biological complexity and variability can be a challenging task. Here we present Simulomics R and our package for generating this kind of data using a generative artificial intelligence model. This package is open source with a strong emphasis on reproducibility, which is achieved through the use of target and RAM package along with version control in GitHub. To ensure that the entire pipeline from the data generation to analysis can be easily replicated and adapted by other researchers. The generated data can be customized according to user-defined parameters such as sample size, biological variability, and experimental design. It can be used also for a range of applications, including the development and testing of new statistical methods for omics data analysis, the comparison of different analysis pipelines, and evaluation of robustness of biological experiment. The package is user-friendly and well-documented, making it accessible to researchers with various levels of problem. Thank you for your attention. And please follow us on these coordinates to see when the package will be released in this full version. Thank you.
So sorry for the video, but it's 8 p.m. here and I have two toddlers that are roaming in the house, so it wasn't predictable if I was if I could do the presentation or not. So I just want to underline that this package is gonna be developed since February. The development is very slow, and we wanted it to be kind of slow because we want it to be methodologically very straight and very reproducible. So maybe on Monday or Tuesday, I don't remember, one of the author, this Corrado Lanera, did a workshop on a reproducibility workflow that we will use for this package. And we are not losing, but it's gonna taking a lot of time to do the things how they should be for us. And we are forcing us to make it not only the results to be reproducible, but also the process of generating the package. So it means that we will document, it's documented also the process that he used to retrieve the data, to clean them, who cleaned them, how, and all the passages. So when the semi-final version of the package will be released, the ones that see in GitHub can expand it and reproduce also the steps that led us to the formal package. I think that this is important and in a way, I learned it also from Daniel's work on GT Summary, because I think that in the biological field and in particular omics data, these facts are a little bit neglected because we are excited to put a package outside. But we need to think it a little more ethically, because yes, it's nice to have a package outside. It's nice to have a package on CRAN, but it has to be useful, not just an exercise. And so the passage was, we saw a problem, and sorry, we saw a problem and we faced it in the
I can, oh, welcome back, welcome back.
Yeah, so I told you that the toddlers are unpredictable.
Can you speak a bit more on how you chose to put it out there versus, you know, kind of keeping it more among you and your colleagues for the public and put it out there for the public?
Yes. So for now, it's for us. Mm-hmm. I mean, we are testing it and we are working with clinical, usually we're working with clinical data, and you cannot put something like a prediction model outside if you don't know that it works 99% of its possibility. We wanted to use that approach also for this kind of package because I work usually with omics data, and since we have some kind of good quality packages for example, transcriptomic packages, but we have also some other packages, maybe not maintained. Also, I think also Davide saw some kind of difficulties in geo repositories that were done with different and old and old instrument. So we wanted like a production grade package, so it can be last for more than a year, more than 5 years to be, is efficient, but are for use for beginners, yes. Also, and we saw it, for example, when we were training the transcriptomic data, we saw, we train transcriptomic data controls and treated, but you will find in description of the file controls, CTRLs, CTRLs, or DMSO, that it's a vehicle for the cells, that it's a control. You can say DMSO, DSMO, and all the kind of stuff. So we semi-automated it. And the most time-consuming part was to control everything, because, for example, for the transcriptomic part, we have 500,000 of samples to check. So that is the most time-consuming. Yes, we wanted the same approach that we had with the clinical data, also with the package, because we think that we don't want to publish 50 articles a year, but 5 well written.
I like that approach. I think it's very measured and a great one to take. You may have said it earlier, but if you had to guess, when do you think this package will be ready to go and ready for everyone?
Yeah, we are waiting for some real computational power that are coming to our department. I think at the end of the summer to do the training, the final part of the training. And I think that for the mid-fall, it's going to be in a realizable form.
Oh, that's fantastic. Mark your calendars, everyone. Mid-fall. Be on the lookout. thank you very much for joining us today, and thank you for the wonderful presentation. Appreciate it.
Thank you.